Hello dear friends, ladies and gentlemen, this is Uncut Fishing and today I'll be using this Maps Aglia TW Copper Colored number 2, one of my favorite spinners, in this small stream. I just arrived, no casts made yet. Right now I'm on a high bank. Oh, there was a take, maybe a good sign, maybe not. Not a large fish. So a few words about the stream. When I headed out today fishing, I wasn't even considering this stream, but on my way I changed my mind. And the reason is that I actually fished this stream before this year, I think even 3 times, which is enormously many for me. And it hasn't produced any of those times, and that's very unusual because it's one of my favorite streams. So I just couldn't believe it, or maybe I'd rather I couldn't accept the fact that it may just need a rest for this year. And when I arrived, actually I'm pretty sorry I did, because the stream is running really low. You can sense that it has been slightly higher due to rains probably, but has dropped again and it's running really low. And probably the wisest thing to do would be to turn around and go somewhere else, even though I spent considering going here and going back to the car at least an hour to get there. So I'll try to stay and fish it for some time, see where it gets me. That first take was pretty nice, but that was a good spot. Usually if fish are on, you can expect a nicer fish there, but in this case not only was that a pretty small fish, but also I didn't manage to... I hooked this one. I tried to take it over those branches, maybe not the wisest thing to do. It got off. Okay, so maybe it's not so bad. 2 fish lost. Already the results from this beginning are much better than from many of my previous visits here. So we'll see how it develops. Yeah, but the stream is running really low. I put on the smaller spinner mostly because I'm using the ultralight rod. Savage Gear Parabellum, 7 feet 1, 2 meters 15 version. And with larger spinners I don't feel it very well. So now we're hitting a pretty shallow stretch with a lot of structures. It's pretty nice when there is a lot of water, but now there's not much to work with. So as you can see, some sort of lowlands jungle out there, but compared to some other streams that I fished, this is actually quite easily accessible. Check out this small, not rather small, but huge structure, but not very large depth for, and my casts are, this is better. There is a small fish in there. Quite unlikely there will be more. I don't know, it's so, oh, as you can see there was a trout. I wanted to say it's so shallow, I'll be checking out low percentage spots, and I thought this was low percentage, but that's a nice fish actually. It came out twice, no interest for the third time, let's wait, but as you can see the depth, it's like this, 20 centimeters, no, less, 15 centimeters, I suspect. Lost interest, damn it. You know what, let's try and use this opportunity to very quickly do a small change. Very shallow. I suspect I should use some kind of a floating crank, and I don't have much to work with. I'm not really much of a crank guy. I could use something really maybe aggressive for change. Here it is. I think it's like a John or something like that, a generic brand. Samsara 70 SP suspended, 70 millimeter long twitching type wobbler. Oh man. Okay, at least it worked. But it was sitting in these tree roots. No hope for it to come out now. But pretty nice fish, pretty nice fish, and three takes already, no fish. Let's stay for a bit with the crank. Usually this run is very productive, but I think, rather I suspect, that the fish that we just had is actually the one that occupies this run as well. For some reason it went downstream into that hiding spot. Maybe it's too hot in this open water, I don't have a clue. It's a very nice open pool for these types of streams. Those are priceless. Okay, let's go back to the spinner. It's very welcome to see that there's not too many mosquitoes out there. That's a pleasant surprise. But as you can, as you saw maybe from those previous fish, maybe the second one was different. It attacked only when I got the spinner closer to where it was actually sitting. But the other fish, especially the last one, it came out after the spinner. It could be in the middle of the stream, it would still come out after it. There is some hole in there. I'm not sure if it's a beaver hole, just an underwater undercut. There it is in there. No, nothing's coming out of that thing. Okay, let's move on. Yeah, but that take from that shallow undercut prompts me now to check out even very shallow spots. And obviously that's dictated by the amount of water. This is a beaver dam, but it seems it's not working. The water's flowing underneath it. maybe very slight difference in elevation. Obviously there will be more silt up there. Actually it's quite a significant difference in elevation, but because the structure is so old, the bottom is covered with sand and mud, and depth wise there is no gain, almost no gain. Small fish shooting around already noticed me. Oh man. That's the first one we landed, I think the fourth take. Not the largest one we saw, but a very nice brown trout. As you can see, the red spots with bluish surroundings are very bright and clear to see. It hit the spinner at the same moment that I lost my sight of the spot due to sun. But it came out of the bank, I suspect. Just like the third fish. I think it was a take. I didn't see that spot due to reflections. I'm almost certain. I suspect a small fish. Visible branch. Don't tell me you have spun around it. Yeah, it snagged. Yeah, it broke. So the spinner line has actually tangled in the branch. That may be very problematic. This time I was lucky. Slightly too high again, but a perfect cast. suspect that first bump was from the fish that's in this entire... Oh, actually I think I saw it. Oh, no, no, there are a lot of small fish, probably not trout. So that may be where the bump came from. Oh, a lot of small fish, probably not trout. Just one bumped into the spinner out of curiosity, I don't know. I'm trying to make it at least a couple of casts into every interesting spot. The first cast is to maybe attract the fish attention if it's there somewhere around, because it seems as if they're going after the spinner. So it may be somewhere different from where I cast, but it may react, and on the second cast it may be already in that same spot. That's my thinking. Oh, tiny trout. Come on. There it is. Off it goes. Try this hole. Nothing's coming out of it. That's a good thing about cloudy, overcast weather and fishing for trout, especially in the morning. It's not an early morning, it's I think past 10 already, but the sun still manages to get me. It's still quite low. And in the early morning, if it's sunny, then it's even worse. Usually there's a pretty good pool over there, but right now it's like a pretty featureless puddle. This run is really, really shallow, and otherwise would be pretty uninteresting, but there's not much to work with. Take small fish. A lot of small bumps again, but small fish. So I suspect this pool will have no biggies in it. Somewhere in the corners. That wasn't a good cast. Man. It's all quite flat. But pretty wide, nice run, pool rather. So as you can see, a lot of, maybe you can see, oh, and not so small fish as well, but a bunch of them, so I suspect that these may be not trout. If those are trout, man, there are like at least 20 of them. Those may be young chub or something like that. Thank you. there is a trout in there, but for some reason it didn't come out when I was casting downstream. Now it saw me, it sort of panicked. That's strange. Obviously it can sense the spinner. It's in there somewhere. No interest. Overhanging grasses are pretty nice. No, nothing came out of them. This is just a cast into nothing. Actually, it would be quite nice to encounter a beaver dam. There used to be a beaver dam there, as you can see, but very long time ago. If it were there now, it would be actually very welcome. More fish swimming around. pretty fast fishing, I must admit. Not a lot of to work with. Here's a nice bend, almost deep, and today's measures and nothing comes out of it. That's the first really disappointing result, because all of the other good spots were actually very low. This one, especially in today's conditions, is a very good hiding spot for larger ones. We saw a couple decent ones, but couldn't hook any so far. A small fish in there. A lot of small fish, actually. Again, I'm not sure those are trout. Is that a trout? Again, a lot of fish of unidentified variety. Sometimes I see one or two that are pretty large. They are quite similar to trout, actually. If those are trout, I'm really surprised. There is a fish there. That's slightly nicer, not as big as the one that we saw before. But a nice dark fish. Off you go. nice undercut for today. And it came out of it, it followed. I suspect those other fish are probably not trout. Seems there is some water flowing, but no, it's too little for trout to sit in there. Similar type of run to the one where we just had a fish, but nothing's coming out. Okay, there used to be a beaver dam up there. We'll see if it still stands because we had some floods. Let's try this tiny undercut. Still there, and it's quite high. I hope it's not too high, because I'm wearing just regular wading boots. Yeah, it's pretty high. Entire pool is very shallow, seems to be covered with silt from rising water. seems pretty featureless, but trout could still be lacking here. Have to make a decision where to go, which bank to take. Okay, I'm on this bank, so let's use this one. And set the hook normally, so it was set to get off. So we lost, I think, 4 or 5 fish, landed 3. Something like that, 4 maybe. But the ones we lost on average were better than the ones we landed. Man, lost one more. Slightly smaller than the one before. Oh man, and the depth. There are a lot of beaver paths and the water, and those things are deep. So this log is really good. There are a lot of opportunities for fish to hide underneath it. And obviously I cannot from this position try it out from the opposite side, for example. But if I cast over it, fish will sense a spinner, and if they are active, they will come out as that one that we just lost did. This undercut is quite deep, but I suspect it's a beaver hole. nice dark bend upcoming. I don't think it will be as deep as it may appear from there. Small fish. Here it is. I still think that that part was probably the best of the bunch. But trout definitely think different. This is slightly nicer. Not a very good take. Come down. That will not be nice. Come on, come on. Some blood. Oh man. I think it got pretty seriously hurt. Actually, if you are one of those with more sensitive nervous system, you could be quite upset, but it's not a given that it won't survive, but just the fact that the gills were damaged. I tried to unhook it as quickly as possible, but I think they were slightly damaged, and it now doesn't look very nice. To help it, because it is just now sinking in mud. Oh, it recovers. I think it should recover. I mean, fish suffer much more serious damage. Sometimes you will find them missing one, missing some part of the body, or having some huge, enormous scars or wounds. I mean, the conditions that they live in, especially if there are floods in the spring. Imagine you have to navigate those streams with tons of rocks and branches and so on. But when I try to push it, it swam away. Let's use this opportunity to check the water temperature. Fish are quite active. It's interesting if water temperature actually reaches 20. No! It's much colder than I thought. So, 17.1 Celsius. Or 62.8 Fahrenheit. So it's pretty normal for the conditions that we have. Mid-August, it was pretty hot, sunny, pretty good actually. And also you can see the amount of water is very small. The bottom is quite dark, the water is standing still. In the evening, it will be much warmer, I suspect. Usually it's believed that anything above 20 degrees or something like 68 Fahrenheit is quite high for trout. The amount of oxygen reduces, it depends on the water temperature to some degree. The colder the water, the more oxygen there is in it, as far as I know. Correct me if I'm wrong. And also, not only oxygen, but I suppose the temperature itself make fish quite passive. But I've had successful fishing sessions in the water that is 21 degrees Celsius. So that's more like 70 Fahrenheit. Obviously, fish still need to feed. trend continues. A lot of small fish in the stream, probably rose from the larger river. So trout have what to actually feed on. Like a couple of meters too short. Not flying. Oh, there was a tick. A small fish. Here it is. Unhooked it without touching it. Pretty nice wide run, but only one small fish. No depth to speak of, except for that tree base, which is actually quite good, but didn't work. sun. This is a very good pool. I just need to find the spot where sun is not shining into my eyes. Okay, a small fish, but much larger one followed. Much larger. Okay, let's hope that second one here it is. I think I'm convinced. I saw a much larger fish swimming alongside that one. Here it is. Oh, that's something worth waiting for. I don't have a landing net. This a really nice specimen. Okay, let's try and unhook him. Pretty thin, actually. Something like 36, 37 centimeters. Some blood coming out of it. I don't know where from, because the take wasn't really bad. So I guess we'll have to wrap it up, folks. Let's make another cast into this nice hole. Oh, there was some other small fish. So I think that this stream has almost regained my confidence, although when I first saw it, the depth, the water level, I was quite pessimistic. So folks, hope you enjoyed this session. If you did, click a like button. It helps. And this was Uncut Fishing. Subscribe. It should be up there somewhere. It helps mostly you, and it's free. You can unsubscribe whenever you wish. And I'll see you next time.